Hey everyone, I'm Alina with Awaken Catholic, and this is Awaken the Saint. There's a common phrase, sometimes you just have to smash some pagan idols to win some hearts. Okay, I totally made that one up. But for today's saint, that's exactly what he did, and is most celebrated for. His way of sharing the beauty of the gospel required him to tear down who they thought God was, both figuratively and literally. Abercius was born and raised in a pagan Russian town in the 10th century. He fell deathly ill as a child and was not seeing an end to his suffering, except through his inevitable death. For whatever reason only known to Abercius, he prayed to the Christian God for healing. Through his prayer, the young man was miraculously healed and thankfully moved to convert to Christianity. When he became a monk, he adopted the name Abraham and carried it with pride throughout the rest of his life. Driven by the power of the Holy Spirit, Abraham traveled around Russia and set his roots officially in Rostov, on the shores of Lake Nero. He began preaching and sharing the gospel with the local villages through powerful conviction. One particular legend about the saint is that he received a vision from St. John the Apostle, where he was given the apostle's personal staff. Just down the road was a local pagan village that worshipped an idol by the name of Velez, and Abraham was called to destroy the false idol and smash it to pieces. Whether or not that's what he actually did, he for sure built a monastery on the site of the old temple, where he continued to preach. He built another church in the honor of St. John. Abraham brought many Russians to Christianity through baptism. He went on to be selected as the abbot and lived out a simple life after his idol-smashing days were done. Like I said in the beginning, you gotta smash a few idols to win a few hearts. Let me explain. Each of us has something in our lives that can be idolized. For some, it might be money, sex, or someone famous. For others, it might be the desire for power or superior vanity. Either way, these idols begin to take over our lives, and we can't imagine going a day without them. We begin to create a fortress around our hearts, not leaving enough room for God. He doesn't desire that for us. He wants to help break open our hearts of stone created by these false idols and set us free in His total, sacrificial love. It's sometimes difficult to do that, I know. For a long time, I idolized the art of perfection. When I fell short, I would crash. It took someone else smashing this idol for me to realize that God desires me as I am, perfectly imperfect. I don't need to be perfect. I just couldn't settle for the low bar faith. What are some idols in your own life? Are you able to smash them down to make room for the true God of the universe? Or do you need accountability smashing it to set your heart free? Can you be there for someone else? Let us ask for the zeal to hold each other accountable in the faith and truth, and to elevate God in our lives. Saint Abraham of Rostov, ora pro nobis.
Thank you for tuning in to Awaken the Saint. Awaken the Saint is made in partnership by Spoke Street Media and Awaken Catholic. For more podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.